the team say?
Can you guys all say team say on three? 1, 2, 3.
Team say!
Hi, I'm Marianne with Team Say. Happy Mother's Day, moms out there. Today we have a treat for the kids and for you. We are at a vaulting competition, the Spring Fest Vaulting Competition at Frying Pan Park in Northern Virginia. What a great place. As you can see behind me, we have the barns with lots of animals. You could bring the kids here anytime. So we are gonna go in and we are going to see a few riders, 60-second rides, where these riders have to do gymnastics on a horse. They have to stand up while the horse is walking or cantering.
You're going to choke on.
We're going to do that. Can you vault for me?
Jake!
Oh, wow!
Jake, go ahead and vault. Let's see.
Jake, let's go.
Let's do it again.
So, Cindy, I'm Marianne with Teen Say, and I understand you're the person to speak to. So, tell us your full name and what you do.
I'm Cindy Rohr. I'm from Suffolk, Virginia.
Okay.
I've been training horses for over 40 years.
Whoa.
In several different disciplines. The main discipline that I actually do is driving. And I am a lunger for Silver Moon. And we have been vaulting for about 12 years. And,
Fancy, and who's this?
This is Fancy.
Hi, Fancy.
Also known as Kneelads Angela, as her registered name.
Ah.
And she's been vaulting for about the same amount of time, about 12 years.
Okay, and she does horse and carriage rides,
you're saying. She's our main carriage horse. She's been doing carriage rides for nearly 15 years.
Wow.
So she's
a really good horse.
Yes,
huh?
She is.
So how old is she?
She's 21. She just turned 21 on May 26th. She had a birthday.
Wow, how long do horses live?
Well, the draft horses live usually up into their 30s. So,
oh, good.
And some make it. I have a friend that's got one in her 40s. So,
wow. Yeah. You have something to say? Fancy, what would you like to say? Do you have something to say?
It's not a treat, Fancy.
Do you have something to add? So how do you, go ahead. So how do you feel when you're out there?
It can be nerve-wracking at times because as a lunger, you're trying to be as perfect as you can be to try to keep the horse as steady as it can be, because that's the difference between having a good round and a bad round. It's a team effort.
Right.
It's a team effort between, and everybody gets a score, the horse, the lunger, and the vaulter.
Gotcha.
So it's, and the nice thing about it is this pas de deux team, they're very forgiving if I make a mistake. And the horse is very forgiving if they make a mistake.
Aww.
So it all works out.
Very good, very good. Have you ever had a ride or fall where you have the horse and you have to do anything fancy really quick? Right, Fancy?
You know, I think Fancy one time years ago here in this arena, I did have somebody that almost fell totally underneath her, and she did everything she could do and did not step on them.
Oh, that's good.
So the horses love these kids, and they do their best. You know, they would not want to hurt anybody.
Right.
She's a mom, too.
Silver Moon vaulters are coached by Cindy Rohr, with coach for Great Falls Vaulter is Stephanie Harris. Lunger for both is Cindy Rohr, and horse Kneelands Angela.
If you didn't know, you move it.
Thank you for inviting us.
Absolutely.
So this is Heather. Tell us your full name, Heather, and how old you are.
Heather Merrill, I'm 33, and I've been vaulting for 20-ish years off and on.
Wow. Okay. And you're a mom, so happy Mother's Day.
Thank you.
You have two kids?
Two little boys, yes. 9 and 5.
And you have a farm, I hear?
We are actually moving out to Oklahoma in 30 days, so we're leaving the East Coast for a while.
Okay. So how long have you had your own horses and been taking care of horses?
I've owned my own horses since I was 8, and then I've managed a barn since about the age of 18.
Wow. So this was a family business first?
Yes. Okay. And then it turned into a competitive vaulting team.
How did that come about?
I had a couple of students that pushed me into competing, kicking and screaming, and now here I am.
Do you win a lot of competitions?
I guess.
And your husband's active military?
Yes.
How do you fit all of this in? Two kids and running the stable? How do you do it? Wonder Woman mom on Mother's Day. How do you do it?
Very little sleep and lots of energy drinks.
Oh. Okay.
We're not pushing those.
What can you tell us about vaulting?
It's one of the hardest sports physically and mentally. You have to be in incredible shape, and you have to have an awesome team of your horse, your vaulter, and your lunger. So it's like a three-man team, and if all the pieces don't fit together, it doesn't go well.
Thank you, Silver Moon Vaulter.
And you really have to trust your partner. This was your partner for...
Yes.
What was that one called?
A pot de deux.
How do?
Yes, we've been working together for almost 2 years, off and on, and Lucy's mother, Cindy, lunges us, and we use her horse Fancy.
Wow. So you guys really, how does the trust work? Like, when you first get started, you're like, how do you pick your partners and know that you're compatible and that you can work together?
I guess it's really whoever you're close to. It's hard to find a partner that you're close to location-wise that you can get together and practice reasonably. So we would make 3-hour trips one way to practice multiple times.
Wow. Well, that makes it fun.
Yeah, it does.
Hey, well, you did great today, and thanks for inviting us.
Thanks for coming out.
Sure. So, Lucy, tell us about you. Yes. You're 18.
Yes, I'm 18. I have been vaulting now for 13 years.
Wow.
So I started when I was just 5 years, little me, 5 years old. First, it just started as just for fun, and then here and there I went to a competition, and then here I am now with Heather, and we decided to do a pas de deux, and at first it was just, let's try this, and now we're competing in the arena together on Fancy. Yeah.
Wow.
We've come a long way.
We have.
Yes.
How many years have you been doing it?
Together, 2, I believe, yes.
So how many competitions roughly is that?
4.
This would be our 4th. We had to do one that was online because of COVID.
It was a virtual fest.
A virtual fest. So they
filmed
us and then we sent our video in.
Well, that's kind of neat.
It was fun.
Yes.
Yeah. At least you were still doing it, right?
Exactly.
Yes, we had a blast.
Good. So, can you ride?
Yes, I do. I help cross train my horse, Fancy, you saw earlier. I do dressage as well, because on the circle, yes, they do need circle and time on the circle, but also you need to build their muscles up in dressage and help them be prepared for the ring in order to carry the vaulters around in the circle.
Did your mom get you into this? How did you get into this?
To vaulting?
To just the whole horse thing.
The whole horse thing. Well, I was born on the farm. Ever since I was little, my mom actually had me on the horse, had her backpack in the barn, and I've been in the barn my whole life around horses, and I just fell in love with it.
Well, that's great. You don't have to do it. You love doing it.
I love doing it. I love just, like, the horsemanship, not just vaulting, just being with the horses and around them. And we don't have, like, many teams around us because we're 3 hours away from here in Suffolk, Virginia.
Oh, okay.
So we have friends all over with doing this competition, and just the bonds, like coming to a competition, it's just so fun getting to see them again.
Oh,
That's so nice. So what advice can you give young riders out there or people that teenagers that decide, hey, I want to try vaulting? What advice can you give?
I would say do what you love and try something new. Go out of your comfort zone. Give it a try.
So what if they've never ridden before?
Actually, if you've never ridden before, in Germany, they actually start with vaulting before they learn how to ride. Because they have handles and they start with the basics, obviously. They're not doing crazy stuff.
Right.
But they learn and it helps their seat and the harmony with the horse and being soft and moving with the horse.
So your music didn't start right away.
Yes, yes.
How did you stay calm? Did it make you lose your...
Well...
Did it rattle you? Then you have to say calm body, calm mind.
Yes, yes. So when that happens, at that point, you just got to give it your all. That happened. It's in the past. I say short-term memory. It happened. What happened, happened. And got to go kill it.
Good. That's a good attitude for everything in life.
Yes.
Yeah. So what about...
He's like, I'm not killing yet, huh? So what about, what did you call the pair thing again?
How to do.
Yes.
Okay, so how did you feel confident doing that? Is there a lot of pressure when you do that? You're so young, too. So
holding a partner the same size, normally, sometimes you have a little flyer, okay? Little flies a little bit easier, but we're a really good pair together because
I'm a really big flyer. The person that's on top is called the flyer, and the
flyer.
Person on the bottom is the base. So I'm a really
just
big,
like cheerleading.
Yes,
I'm a really big flyer, but she is very, very, very good at basing me, and I trust her to hold me upside down. So
and that's the big thing is it's all trust.
It is.
It's all trust.
Did you have a dropper?
We are trained how to tuck and roll and fall off safely. And
yes.
So when we first start, we hit the ground a lot.
So that's the first thing we actually learn to do.
That?
One of the first things we do. We have pads and we practice to tuck and roll safely and to exit quickly and as safe as possible.
Well, thank you for being so hospitable and inviting us out,
of course.
Texting me yesterday.
Yes.
Happy Mother's Day.
Thank you. Happy Mother's Day to you too.
And good luck in the competition.
Thanks.
Today we're with Julie Hansen and her daughter Elise, and we're going to talk to them about the Spring Fest Vaulter Competition. Thank you for being with us today, Julie.
Absolutely.
Elise, nice to see you again.
Good to see you too.
So, tell us how you organize this. How does this begin?
We're Topaz Vaulters, and we operate under the American Vaulting Association's guidelines. And the preparation for this competition starts back in January. And you start off with establishing weekends, making accommodations with the judges, reaching out and finding out when they're available. There's a number of judges across the country, and you get a facility, and you just start to work your way through the process. And then we notify the AVA, American Vaulting Association, and it goes into their website. And people then in the area can enter through that website.
So you had teams from just Northern Virginia and Maryland, or did they come from all over?
They came from a pretty good range. We had teams from New York, New Jersey, Pennsylvania, and
wow.
North Carolina.
Wow. How many teams were here?
A total of 15 teams participated.
Wow.
Yeah.
Okay. So how long have you had a vaulting team?
Well, Elise and I started vaulting in 2011, and I took over the team in 2017.
Wow, okay.
Yeah, it's been fun. It's been a growth experience, definitely.
Yes, and you have your own horses.
Yes, so we own one horse, and the club actually owns a horse as well.
Okay. So tell us, how do they judge these kids? What are the age requirements to be a vaulter?
You can be almost as young as you want. I've seen vaulters at 2 and 3 years old.
No.
Yes, and vaulters well into their 50s and 60s. So we can accommodate a wide range. When it comes to competing, age 5 is probably about the youngest that you're really going to find most kids starting to compete.
Okay. So what's the caliber? Like, so somebody mentioned silver something. So run us through the...
Yeah. That's the great thing about vaulting. Is you compete against other people of your skill level. So we can go from competing at the walk up to competing at the canter. And within each gait, you have multiple levels based on your skills and abilities. So if you can't, at the canter, if you can't get on the horse by yourself, you compete against other people who need that boost. If you're getting on the horse by yourself, then you start off at the one canter level, and from there it moves on up. So it's kind of like golf, where golfers are handicapped. There are different levels at which people compete so that it's very fair and equitable.
Okay. And what they said was, like, a five-year-old could compete against Elise, who's 19?
She's a canter vaulter, so probably not. And we also have specific age ranges for the five-year-olds. We have a group called Tiny Tots. Aww. And they are adorable.
Yes. Oh, my goodness. We didn't get those this time, but next time we will definitely get them.
Yeah. But there can be younger competitors against me.
Yes.
As long as they're at my level.
So how do the judges judge them? Are there, like, a certain amount of stunts they have to do? Go ahead. I know they have 1 minute.
Yes. So for the, there's two basic forms of competition: compulsories, which is the same moves done, and there is no time limit on that. And then they have a freestyle, which has a time limit of 1 minute.
Okay.
And the judge judges against a perfect score. So if you're a younger, inexperienced vaulter, your scores might be down in the 2 to 3 range. If you've just done something perfectly, the ultimate expression of that move, you'd get a 10. So it scores from 0 to 10.
Okay. And in freestyle, is there a certain amount of moves or no? Like, does everybody have to do to stand up to, or it depends on the criteria that they're...
It depends on the level they're competing at and the criteria they need to meet for that level. They evaluate, the judges evaluate performance, they evaluate degree of difficulty. Mm-hmm. So it's a broad range. And that's one of the fun things about freestyle, because you can make it your own.
Right. So you also lunge the horses, which means you hold them while the rider goes around. So you're actually in control. So a person vaulting doesn't have to know how to ride a horse.
Correct. They don't have to have any horse experience at all.
That's crazy to me.
Yeah, well, and the clubs are nice because you can come into an organization that's already got the horses, got the experience, and you can learn from there. And if you want to ride, you can add riding in. You know, it just gives you that introduction to horses. It's like dipping your toe in the water. You check it out first. It's really fantastic.
Wow.
And the club also builds leadership and teamwork, because our vaulters help each other and they coach each other, and they learn throughout their lifetime.
So back to you lunging. Elise took a fall.
Yes, she did.
And we're going to show that. We're going to hear from Elise. But how do you deal with that as a mom and as the head of the team?
Yeah, so it's expected that people will fall, right? Mm-hmm. It's a horse sport and things unexpected can happen.
Not a lot, though.
Correct, and vaulting is one of the safest, if not the safest, horse sport. Because
it's crazy.
I know, they're standing on the back of a horse.
Yeah.
But it's in a controlled environment.
Uh-huh.
It's in soft footing. You know, if they come off of the horse, they're not necessarily falling against a jump or out in the fields against a fence. You know, that's a very open environment there. So when they come off, odds are that nothing very serious is going to happen.
So Lucy told us that, as someone else we interviewed, Lucy said they actually practice tucking and falling.
Yeah, we have unintentional fall clinics where you learn how to come off the horse.
That's very good.
It
so
is.
How do you know when somebody's ready to compete or get up there versus, you know, because they're practicing on the barrels first, mm-hmm. before they ever go on top of the horse. So how do you know when they're ready to compete?
It really varies from person to person.
Mm-hmm.
Some folks have more of a challenge getting used to going from the barrel, which is stationary, to the moving horse. But
yeah.
Most people can make that adjustment pretty quickly at the walk. And then from there, moving up to the trot or the canter is not only a matter of your ability to do the moves, but it's a matter of your physical fitness,
right.
and your strength to be able to hold the moves on that moving person. So we evaluate each vaulter to look at where they are skill-wise,
mm-hmm.
what has the feedback been from judges, and then we also have a physical test that they have to pass before they get to move up to the next level.
Okay. Such as?
Yeah, physical test. It's one that we've put together ourselves. You know, so to be able to go out and jog, say, a half a mile.
Oh.
And come back into the ring and do sprints.
Okay.
A certain number of push-ups, you know, leg lifts, squats, V-ups, burpees, things like that are assessing, and to do them, you know, one after the other, where you can really get a feel for their level of strength.
And balance, right?
Yeah, we do have a one-legged balance thing.
Yeah.
You have to, like, hold your leg up.
Yep.
For, like, 30 seconds.
Okay. And this competition goes up to 50-year-olds? No, I'm just kidding. They're still doing that?
Yep. And actually, our club has a master's vaulter who is over 50. She was not here this weekend, but she has been competing with us for several years.
Wow.
Yeah.
Wow, good for her. Yes. So tell us, how did you feel when Elise fell?
Yeah.
What did you...
As a lunger, you expect to deal with that. It was very difficult to see her fall because she fell out of the stand. And my first reaction was, oh God, I hope she's okay. I'm there in the middle. And somebody came to me very quickly and took the horse from me so I could go up and be with her. So that was good. As I said, you know, odds are against an injury here. So once you get over the initial shock, you realize that things are going to be okay and you move on. But it's always, and as a lunger, I feel guilty too, because it's like, should I have done something differently?
Well, no,
did I contribute to this?
Your horse actually tripped in the sand.
He did.
So there was nothing you could do.
There was nothing, And we had the video evidence of that. So I felt better after that.
Yeah, of course. And I love her answers, because it's the same with anything. It's like ice skating and cheerleading. I mean, they're not supposed to fall when they're flying and they're up there, but they do. What advice do you think you could give teens out there? I mean, when something happens, I mean, you're working through it. So many teens, like, give up after something happens. How would you tell them to get a different mental status to?
Yeah, as long as it's not, like, a super serious injury. Like, mine, luckily, wasn't serious. I mean, I think it's another thing to tear an ACL, though I believe you can come back from those. It'll be hard. It's going to be hard work, and there are going to be days when you're able to do it, and then there are going to be other days where you're just not feeling it. You just, if you really want it, you need to go after it. You need to dedicate yourself to doing it and do it over and over again. Doesn't matter if it's good or not. Improvement, just getting back into it and working on trying to be better.
So what do you want to tell people out there if they're thinking about vaulting?
I think you should go for it. As I said, it's a fantastic sport. It's very welcoming. We look at leadership. You know, in our team, we have the kids coach each other. There's a growth mindset to it. You will always learn something new with the horse. You'll always learn something new as you're doing your moves. You get to interact with these beautiful animals and learn to love and respect them. And hopefully, you know, with vaulting, you're creating a lifelong activity. You're creating the physical fitness that goes along with it to stay physically active as you grow.
Yeah. So the horses, what criteria do they have to meet to become vaulting horses? Like, I mean, you go on some horse trails and your horse is really obnoxious and wants to run back to the barn. And so how do you judge the horses?
So if you're starting off with a horse who's never vaulted before and you're looking to find one to vault on, you really need to look at the horse's temperament and trainability. That's first and foremost. If they don't have a good temperament, then you're not going to get them to vault, because it's very different from the riding sports.
Yeah.
And when you take a riding horse and retrain them for vaulting, they're learning a new skill set. You know, so one of the things...
How long does it take to teach them a new
skill set?
Yeah,
it can vary from horse to horse.
Okay.
We have a Percheron mare, very trainable, fantastic temperament. She was vaulting within probably about 30 or 60 days.
Wow.
She was really quick, yeah.
Wow.
We have a thoroughbred Percheron cross who was here this weekend, and he's vaulting, but he's still not...
Was that the black one?
Yeah.
Well, they both
are black. Yeah, he's huge.
They're huge, my goodness.
Gentle giants, though. Definitely gentle giants.
They're beautiful.
And he's still learning, because at the higher, at the faster gates, like the canter, the vaulter's balance makes a difference. It shifts the horse's weight around in a way that they're not used to.
Right.
When you ride, you're typically sitting above the horse's center of gravity.
Right.
When you're sitting behind a vaulting surcingle, you're actually a little bit behind the center of gravity. And you're also doing asymmetric moves, which can pull the horse's weight one way or the other. You're getting up on their neck, where they're not necessarily used to feeling that weight. And sometimes you're getting back on their rear end too. So they have to carry you differently. So it really will vary from horse to horse. Our guy is coming along nicely, I'm happy to say.
Well, that's great. Yeah. And so you talk about them building bonds with the horses. So how do you have them build a bond with the horses? Like if they've never been around horses and they're a little fearful, but they want to start vaulting, is there a certain thing that you do with them?
Absolutely. We bring them into the barn. They get introduced to the horses. They help to groom and prepare the horses for going out and vaulting on them. They get the opportunity to lead the horses around the ring. When they're sitting on the horse, we have them do all kinds of just basic moves. You'll have them lie down on their stomach and reach up and pet the neck, touch the ears, lean way back and touch the tail. Just get them accommodated to that motion of the horse.
Yeah.
Yeah. And the handling of the horse, I think, is really one of the best ways to get used to being around them because they are big.
Yes. Do most of them start riding after that? Like, do they want to ride as well?
You know, it really varies. Okay. And we do get some riders who come into vaulting because it's a fantastic sport to teach you good seat and balance.
Yeah.
Because, you know, when you're riding, you've got stirrups that help you maintain your balance. Like I said, you're sitting above the horse's center of gravity. But when you vault, you're not. And you don't have those stirrups anymore. And you do have to rely on your balance more. And you're doing moves. You know, you'll get up onto your knees. You'll stand on the horse's back. You'll do leg passes. So you're sitting on the side of the horse. So lots of stuff.
Elise showed us, I don't know if she told you, she showed us vaulting on the barrels. So she did a bunch of moves and showed us how it goes. Definitely a lot different than when you're standing on a horse.
I've
had a canter.
Yeah.
Tell them what a canter is.
So a horse has four gates.
So a canter is like a fast trot, just so they know.
So you have walk, you have trot, which is kind of like a jog. A canter, I'd say, is more of like a run. And then they have the gallop, which we don't vault on, which would be like a sprint.
Wow.
Yeah. Yeah, the trot is a two-beat symmetrical gait, and you'll see dogs, you know, and cats go out and trot. The canter is a three-beat gait with a moment of lift in it. So it, in of itself, is asymmetric, which brings more challenges to it.
So, Julie, tell us, the name of the association is what?
So the governing body for vaulting in the United States is the American Vaulting Association.
Okay. And we can find teams through them?
Yes, you can. They have a find a team in your area portion of their website.
Okay.
And it'll take you to a team at any part of the country.
Wow. Yeah. And they're nonprofit.
They are nonprofit, as are we.
Awesome. Yep. Well, thank you. Mm-hmm. And if you're looking for a team here in Virginia,
Topaz
Julie and
Walters.
Elise, would love to meet you at Topaz. Thank you so much.
The Crumpet, Coach Alexandra DeRussia. Lunter, Emily Calarico, and Boulder, Alexander, and Russia.
This is...
I'm Alexandra DeRusha and I'm 20 years old.
So what did you just do?
I did my silver freestyle. Silver's the level that I vault at. Freestyle is when you get to do kind of whatever moves you want to do, whatever you like. And as levels increase, you get to do harder moves. So that's what I just did. You get music, costuming. It's really fun.
Yeah, and you really have to be good at gymnastics to be able to do this.
Yeah, I mean, we practice gymnastics. I'm not a gymnast either.
So how did you decide to just start doing this?
So my friends are actually here. They've been my friends since I was 4 years old. They were at a fair, and they saw this great big horse. They went to talk to the owner, and the owner was like, yeah, we actually do this thing called equestrian vaulting. And they were like, oh, really? And then they joined. I was just like, take me with you.
I gotta do this too.
And that was it.
Wow, okay.
And here we are 10 years later.
So what's the training? You just get up there and you just start doing moves? I mean,
we have this
thing. At 10 years old?
We have this thing called a barrel. It's like a barrel and a half.
Okay.
And you can either weld them, if they're plastic, there's all kinds of different things you can do. Okay. And then they have handles on them to simulate a horse. You can practice all the moves you want. We do things called drills. So you do moves that are similar to the moves that you compete. Help strengthen yourself, kind of like exercises.
Right.
You do other exercises, like you gotta have a strong core, strong arms, legs.
So have you won a lot of competitions?
Yeah, I've won quite a few. I've lost quite a few, but yeah. It's all part of it.
Yes. Is it usually like a whole weekend competition?
Usually it's a whole weekend. Nationals is usually like 4 days, just because there's so many people, but... Yeah, it's usually a weekend.
So where are nationals? Does it change?
It changes.
Yearly?
It changes every year.
Okay, where is it this year?
This year?
That's okay.
I don't know. I'm not going, and I'm not going because of distance. It's more west.
Okay. So you had some problems during or before? What happened?
So we rely a lot on our music because we know like when our music starts and when it ends. We have 60 seconds to do a freestyle. So a lot of us know like where in our music 60 seconds is, or like right before. So if we're running late for whatever reason, we can dismount really quickly, because for every second that you go over, you start to lose points. So a lot of us have our music memorized, and we have hand moves. It's kind of like a dance.
Yeah.
So you use your music. And today when I was doing my round, first of all, I raised my hand to start the music, and then it didn't start right away. When it did start, it was like already a few seconds in, so I was late getting on the horse. And then once I was on the horse, I'm doing my routine, and then it's silent. And then when the music restarted, it was back at the beginning. So I had no use for my music.
Can't you ask the judges at that point to start the music again and start? But it's their own.
It is what it is. It is what it is. If they play the wrong music, you can change the music and do whatever you need to do. Like that girl after me, how she was able to fix her problem.
Because
she hadn't
touched
the handles. The second you touch the handles,
right,
your minute starts. Whatever happens after that minute starts, it is what it is. If you don't touch the handles, you can fix problems. Other than that, it is what it is.
So being that they messed up the music, will they take that into consideration?
Because
they don't know what your moves were supposed to be.
No.
Or what, you know what I mean? So you still didn't mess up any of your moves, right?
How they judge things, there's different categories. They judge the horse, how well the horse goes. They judge, it's called general impression, which is your general overall composure and professionalism.
Which is good.
So if you,
in my opinion,
if you handle the situation well,
yes,
and you do as you're supposed to do, you get a higher score for that. Like, if he were to have messed up the music and I would have went, like, what are you doing? My score would have gone down. But I just continued my routine as it was.
Okay.
So factors into it. So that score could be raised because I handled that situation well. Other than that, though, everything else gets judged pretty much the same. Like, my moves are scored individually, all of that. So,
great.
Yeah. So, a little bit to answer your question.
So, what do you want to tell people out there about vaulting? Do you want to give them any advice, teens, young kids that want to start doing this? How do they get involved?
If you want to start doing it, my best advice is to go to the American Vaulting Association website. And there's a little tab on there somewhere where you can find teams. There's a map and you can find a team near you. Around here, if you're in Virginia, you'll probably find, what was their name? Topaz. If you're in Northern Virginia, maybe Great Falls. Those are both the two teams that are hosting.
Okay.
If you're more Southern, you get Silver Moon. So if you're in Virginia, those are the teams you want to try to contact.
Thank you.
If you're anywhere else in the country, then just go on the website and they'll tell you. If you want to start doing it yourself, I suggest a lot of research because it takes a lot, and trying to find someone that does know what they're talking about to help you.
So do you have your own horse?
Our team has a horse, so okay. It's not mine. One of the other teammates, they own the horse, but the whole team uses her.
What's the horse's name?
Our horse's name is the Crumpet. We've had her for as long as I've been vaulting. So
how old is she?
I believe she's 16.
Okay.
16, 17.
All right. And how many girls are on the team?
Well, we have four here today.
You on the spot today.
We have four here
You're
today.
Our first interview today. So thank you for all the education. I know nothing about vaulting. Do you, Tom? I think it's great. It's awesome. I actually rode when I was younger.
Oh, yeah?
English and showed, but never thought
it's
or dreamed about
something
vaulting.
Anyone can get into. But we have four girls here today, including myself. Back at home, we have 1, 2, 3.
It's okay.
We have, I believe there's 9 of us total.
Okay.
I think. Okay. I don't know. I've been in college, so there's like some kids that I haven't even met on the team yet.
Oh, okay.
I just kind of came straight here from.
So, are you practicing when you're at college? Do you come home during break?
Come home like every 2 weeks, so I get a practice in every 2 weeks. That's all I get.
So now you were saying you didn't know how to horseback ride at first. You just went straight to vaulting. How does that work?
Well,
what do you do? I mean, because so they're controlling the horse.
Yeah, with vaulting, it's the lunger that controls the horse, which I actually also picked up because we needed to. We lost our lunger.
Oh, okay. So now you're a lunger too.
Yeah. I coach the team, I lunge the team, and I vault myself. So do two of the other girls because when I went away to college, I'm like, you guys have to coach. So, yeah, there's three of us doing a working effort there. But for vaulting, it's the lunger that worries about the horse. All you have to do is focus on you. And if there's something going on with the horse, just try not to fall off. It's the lunger's job to control that. You don't really have to worry about that. Riding, of course, helps because it helps with your posture, your strength, your ability to know the horse.
Yes.
But it's not necessary. Same thing with dance and gymnastics. They always help, but not required.
Wow, thank you so much. Good luck today.
Thanks.
I can't wait to see what your score is.
Yeah, me too. But I won't find out until the weekend's over because since I've been away at college, I can't mount the horse by myself, which is a requirement for my class.
Oh.
So I'm only getting scores. I'm not actually competing. I'm just vaulting for fun and to see what the judge thinks.
Oh, okay.
But I'm not competing against the other girls. So I'm not going to get a ribbon. But that's okay. I have enough.
It's nice to meet you both. So these are the judges. And what is the name of this competition?
This is the Great Falls Topaz Spring Fest. And we've done it every year except for last year for as long as I can remember. In fact, I used to vault in this competition 100 years ago.
So how many years has it been going on, roughly? If you had a guess.
Well over 20. I remember vaulting here in 95. So, and it had been going on long before that. So,
so you guys, you're a judge and you're a clerk. Tell us your names.
I'm Jennifer Daniels.
I'm Gabrielle Evans.
So how long have you been judging?
Five years,
I believe. Yeah.
Clerking?
About a year now.
So what does it entail to clerk?
To clerk, I am kind of as a scribe for the judge. So while the judge is looking and focusing on the actual equestrian vaulting, I'm writing down scores and tallying up totals for the end result.
So is she saying stuff that you have to write down as well?
Yes.
Okay, that's what you meant by the scores. Okay. So she's scoring. Okay, so what are you doing? What are you judging?
A lot. So I'm judging the horse. I'm judging the vaulters. So I'm judging their technique. It's very similar to ice skating and.
I was gonna say that about the costume.
Yeah,
and the,
and it is. It's very similar. So we judge artistic. We judge technique. Now, in bigger competitions, judges are doing different things. So there'll be an artistic judge and a technique judge. But for the smaller competitions, we do it all. Which is why we rely on our scribes so much to get down all of the things we're saying in our.
So you have to be fast.
Yes.
I try.
Yes.
So, okay, in the case of one of the riders said her music messed up, you know, they messed up the music. So how do you judge the rider? She said once they touch, she has to keep going.
Yes.
So do you know that that's happened? Like.
So they actually, we have it in our rules that they can request a music timeout so that they can address music issues. There's also things in our rules that allow for unforeseen circumstances, and that's kind of along those lines. Now, if she had touched, started her routine, and something went off with the music, too bad.
Yeah, that's what she said. And then she said if they act professional, though, you still know it's, what, how do you?
So as long as they haven't touched or begun the.
But if they have, in her case she did, and then the music paused, but then it started from the beginning again, throwing off her routine. So what? How does that work?
It kind of just depends on how well they hide it, honestly, because that there's not a whole lot we can do at that point. Like,
because it's already started.
Like the show goes on, you just have to keep going, right?
Just like ice skating.
Exactly. And the really good vaulters, you would never know anything happens because they fake it until they make it. You
right.
know?
So,
okay.
Right. Okay, so judging. Tell us about it. So you're judging the horse. What are you looking for?
Horse. So we're looking for a horse that's moving well. We actually use kind of the training scale that you would look at for dressage to get our horse score, but we also need the horse to be safe and vaultable, meaning that the kids can actually do their routines. So obviously like a high level dressage horse would not be ideal for vaulting because their movement would be difficult to vault on. So we're looking for a horse who's moving forward, who's cantering if that's the gait that they're doing, smoothly and consistently. But we also want to see a horse who's moving through, who's straight on the circle, and who can carry themselves and is balanced. And is well-behaved. Number one, well-behaved. So we start judging the horse as soon as the vaulter touches the handles. We do judge the general impression, everything that happens other than that during their time in the arena. So
how does it, like, so how high can their score be? What's the score like?
1 through 10, just like gymnastics, or I think they might have changed gymnastics scoring recently, but it's essentially the 1 through 10.
Okay.
So, and the hard thing is the tiny tots, the little, like, babies, are being judged in the same scale that our gold-level vaulters are, so.
They compete against the big ones?
They're in their own little sections, but it's still, like, essentially the same rules with different degrees of difficulty throughout the layers of different competitions. So aside from tiny tots, there's no age differential though. So a 20-year-old could be vaulting against a 12-year-old in its ability versus age, which is different than a lot of other sports.
Yes. Yeah. What's your the youngest and oldest age you've ever had against one another? Do you remember?
I have no idea.
So what else do you want to tell us?
Vaulting is a great sport. It's one of the safest equestrian sports, and find a team and come try it out.
Okay, thank you so much, both of you, for talking to us. Have a happy Mother's Day.
You too.
Thank you.
So we're back here with Alex. Alex, we wanted to ask you, so it was brought to my attention that when you started coaching, you were only 14?
Yeah, I was her age.
She's 14!
Yeah.
What?
So we had a coach who passed away. So
I'm sorry.
Thanks. At that point, me and my friend, who is a year older than me, we kind of took over the team and started coaching these girls, who were brand new at the time. So, yeah, we started coaching. I was 14, and then I just kind of kept doing it for the past 6 years. And
hey, Mom, do you want to talk to you?
And then I've coached.
She's proud of you, though.
I've coached her and her sister to also coach and lunge and do all they need to do with these girls. So not only did I coach them to vault, I coached you to coach.
So how did she start so young?
She was really good. She has really great leadership skills. That's what I'll say about her. So when Linda left us, which we were very sad about, she just stepped up to the plate and started doing what needed to be done because she loved the sport. She knew the girls who were younger than her loved the sport, and we just wanted to keep it going. And we're from Western Pennsylvania, where there weren't a lot of teams for anybody to go to. So it was either we kept it going or vaulting would end at that point in time. So,
so Mom, what's your name?
Kelly.
Kelly. So Kelly, do you have horses? Do you?
No.
Are you a rider?
No. She had friends who were horse people and they pulled her into it. And I know more about horses than I ever thought I would.
Yeah.
You know, I help when I can, but it's not my wheelhouse.
Got you. So tell us about you. What's your name?
Emily Tellerico.
Okay, Emily, and you're only 14?
Yeah.
So you're a lunger.
Yes, and I also do vaulting too.
Oh, okay. But you're not competing today in vaulting.
I am.
She is later. That's why I'm dressed like this, so I can lunge her.
Oh, okay. So how long have you been lunging?
This is my first year doing it at competitions and stuff, but I've been vaulting for like 7 years now.
You look very efficient.
Thank you.
So is this just riding pants, the blazer? Is this the way we're supposed to dress?
We're pretty standard. Like most people dress pants of some kind, either riding boots like that, paddock boots, and then a dress shirt. You can wear a blazer. Some people wear just shirts. Some people wear like these.
Gotcha.
It's different, but this is pretty standard.
Yeah, it looks like when I was writing English, it looks like kind of the same.
Yeah, it's the same deal.
Blazer?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, it's just an English jacket.
So, what was I going to say? So, how long have you been vaulting?
7 years now, I think.
7 years. So
how did you get into it?
I would ride with my horse, and we went to a pony camp in Rolling Rock, and they had a demo there, and so that's how I started, like, finding out about them, and I just did it, went to a practice, and have done it since then.
Yeah. Remember you guys being at that demo. That was a wild demo.
7 years old? How old were you there?
Seven.
Wow. Tell us about lunging. How do you feel when you're doing it? Because you're responsible for the rider.
Yeah, so it is a little, you get like nervous and stuff, but I've worked with the horse a lot. I ride her and stuff, so it's really just, you know, you kind of,
I don't know how to explain it.
It's knowing what needs to happen before it happens. So if it looks like she's going to slow down a little bit, that means, that means you got to give a cue or use the whip a little bit. And it's just like knowing your horse, and because she works with her so often.
you kind of learn those things.
Yeah. Yeah.
You're welcome.
So what's your horse's name?
Crumpet.
Crumpet, okay. And how many horses do you have?
We only have one for competition, like vaulting. And
but do you have one at home as well?
Yeah, I have three horses at home that I ride just like riding and stuff, you know. Just all.
So at what age did you start riding?
Well, I grew up on a farm and stuff, so I've been riding since I was young, real little. I don't know, just
2, 3, 4, 5.
Yeah, just, I don't know, like 3 or 4, around there.
This is hard.
This is rough.
Okay, well, do you have anything else you want to add?
Oh, I think that's it.
Okay, I know. It's rough. She's dying over here. Did you hear that? This is rough. Okay, we're going to go watch Elise do some barreling, unless Alex wants to teach us anything else.
I think that's it.
Yes. Thank you for the education today.
Thank you for being with us today. We hope you enjoyed the vaulters. We hope you consider trying vaulting or at least go to a horse show. They're such a blast. Frying Pan Park has so many horse shows. We go all the time. The kids just love it. So get out there. It's beautiful out and enjoy the day.